In this example, we are given that a particle is thrown from ground at an angle 30 degree with the horizontal at 40 meters per second. We are required to find the time duration for which it will be at a height more than 10 meters above the ground. So, if we first draw the physical situation, you can simply state, say this is the ground on which we can consider the x direction, and say this is the point of projection which we take as origin. We are given that a particle is thrown at an angle of 30 degree with the initial speed of 40 meters per second. It follows a projectile motion and finally hit the ground somewhere else. We are required to find the time duration for which it will be at a height more than 10 meter above the ground. Now in this situation, if we talk about more than 10 meter above the ground, say there are two positions, one is here, other is here. Because we can easily check the value of maximum height, which is equals to u square sine square theta by 2g. The value of maximum height will be u square will be 1600 into sine square 30 degree will be 1 by 4 divided by 20. So you can see this will give us 160 by 8, that is 20 meter. So maximum height to which the ball will be raised is 20 meter. We are required to find the time when the ball is above 10 meters. So there are two positions which are at a height of 10 meters. So at this position, the particle was at time t1 and at this position it was at time t2. Then we are required to find the time delta t, which is t2 minus t1. Now in this situation, we already studied that whenever we are required to analyze the time, we need to use the motion in y direction. We can see when the particle was thrown at 40 meters per second, its vertical velocity with which it was thrown is 40 sine 30 degree, that will be 20 meters per second. So it goes up, reaches the maximum height and then comes down. So we can say in y direction, if we write the relation h is equals to uyt minus half gt square, you can put h is equals to 10 is equals to 20t minus, if we take g equals to 10, it is 5t square. That will give us t square minus 4t plus 2 is equals to 0. Now solving this, we'll get the value of time, that is 4 plus minus root of b square minus 4ac, that will be 16 minus 8 divided by 2. So the result we are getting here is 2 plus minus root 2 second. So there are two values of time we can see. At one time t1, one particle is reaching the height 10 meter, that will be 2 minus root 2 seconds. And t2 is the time when it is again at 10 meter, that is 2 plus root 2 second. So here when we substitute the values, we will get the time for which it was above the 10 meter height, that will be t2 minus t1. This will be 2 root 2 seconds. So this will be the answer to the question.